Hey everyone, Dylan Schumacher, Citadel Defense. And today we're going to talk about rights and why they're important. So I will not run in the whole clip here, but you can watch it in the description below. But I came across this tweet the other day from some random person that had a Sky News clip in it. And in Australia, they had taken two different apartment complexes and completely locked them down due to coronavirus. By completely locked them down, what I mean is they surrounded them with police. They won't let anyone in or out of these apartment buildings for at least 5 days. Like, there's no reason you're allowed to leave your apartment at all. They're putting police on different floors of the apartment buildings to make sure no one leaves, and possibly enforcing door-to-door testing. I'm not sure. That wasn't in the news story, it was in the tweet, but I don't know. Either way. So, here's the point. Never, ever give up your guns. People might say, okay, that's insane, Dylan. What does that have to do with it? I mean, we're just being safe and people are sick. First of all, coronavirus, last I knew, has something like a 99% survival rate. But just taking that aside anyway, just set that aside. Pretend it actually is really super dangerous and people are hurting. You're locking people in their homes against their will without them having committed any kind of crime. That is a massive violation of human rights and sovereignty, any way you want to slice it. That's a huge rights violation. So this is what happens to a populace that is unarmed and unable to do anything about it. They ultimately live under the tyranny of those with power. That has been the story of human history since the beginning. The people who have power rule those who don't. That's where the phrase might makes right comes from, which means if you have power, you can do whatever you want and no one can stop you, because what you do is morally right because you have the might, right? Might makes right. I have the power, I can do what I want, and no one can really stand in my way. Social Darwinism, quasi-Nazistic, it's just tyrannical. It's authoritarianism, it's tyranny, it's existed since the beginning, and it will until Jesus comes back. So the biggest and best safeguard to tyranny and safeguard from you being locked into your house or your apartment building or them enforcing door-to-door vaccinations without your consent, the biggest safeguard to that is an armed populace, right? This is America. We have more guns than people, thank God Almighty. And one of the things that that provides us is a safeguard that, hey, if you want to force a bunch of people to do a bunch of things, that might be dangerous for you and you might want to think about that first. And that's a good, wonderful thing. That's why we have the Second Amendment, right? To resist tyranny and protect liberty from threats, foreign and domestic. Okay, that's pretty basic history stuff. I know you're not supposed to say that stuff nowadays, but that's actually why the Second Amendment exists. So, again, people will say, well, Dylan, why are you all upset? Why are you about gun rights? What's your big problem? Why are you so mad about stuff like this? Because when you give up gun rights, this is where it leads. It leads people to being locked in buildings. The government's supposedly going to bring them food. It leads to massive starvation. Look at China when they adopted communism, for instance. Tens of millions of people starved to death. We don't even really know how many. Because, of course, China doesn't disclose those numbers. Who even knows if they kept accurate track? So this is what happens. This is what happens. As soon as we give up the guns, the rest of our rights follow shortly thereafter. Gun rights are the vanguard of liberty. And without gun rights, without us actually physically owning and possessing and keeping arms, we're in a position of disadvantage to those who do have them. So don't give up your gun rights. Don't give up your guns ever, because as soon as you do, the rest of your rights will quickly disappear. I think that's pretty obvious from history. I think that's extremely clear in this case. Would love to know what you think. Do brave deeds and endure.